In this illustration, we'll study about equipotential surfaces in a surrounding of a dipole. Here, the situation is analyzed as a dipole of moment P is placed. This P vector is placed in a uniform electric field with E vector parallel to P vector. And in surrounding of dipole, there exists a spherical equipotential surface and we are required to find its radius. So here, if we draw the situation here, we can see if this is a dipole with the dipole moment P vector, it is placed in a uniform electric field which is parallel to this dipole. So this is the uniform electric field E vector left to right. And the direction of electric field is parallel to dipole moment vector. So we are required to find the radius of a spherical equipotential surface. So by taking this dipole as a center, if I draw a spherical surface and if I consider this to be an equipotential surface, that means any point A, if we consider on this surface, any other point on the surface will have same potential. But in the electric field, if two points are displaced, they are having some potential difference which is given by ED, where D is the separation between the two points. So if A and B are at same potential, then whichever potential drop is there due to this electric field, which is the external electric field, we know, we have studied that in the direction of electric field, potential decreases. So B will be at lower potential, A will be at high potential in this electric field. So whichever potential drop is there between two points due to external electric field must exactly be compensated by the potential difference due to this dipole. Then only we can see that the two points will be at same potential. See, if we consider these two points which are symmetric with respect to the dipole and say they are located at an angle theta and theta from the axis of dipole, then here we can see electric potential at points A and B are, these can be easily calculated due to the dipole. Here we are writing this due to dipole. So if we calculate this electric potential, we can simply write the expression, and as this theta is taken from the opposite side or from the negative side, we can take its potential to be minus of kp cos theta by r square. And here vb can be given as it is taken from the positive side, it is kp cos theta by r square. So here we can calculate due to dipole, the potential difference Vb minus Va, the difference of these two points, difference of potential at these two points, we can write as it will be Vb minus Va, so it will be 2kp cos theta by r square. So in this situation, this is the increase in potential due to dipole. So if we calculate the potential difference between points A and B due to electric field is, this potential difference Va minus Vb can be calculated as ED, where D is the separation between the two points as the field is uniform. And this separation, you can see, can be directly given as if this distance is taken as R. This will be 2R cos theta. So I can write it as E multiplied by 2r cos theta. So here for A and B to be at same potential, we use here these two potential differences, which is due to dipole and which is due to external electric field, must be equal. Here Vb minus Va due to dipole must exactly compensate Va minus Vb, which is due to external electric field. So if we equate the two, this will give us 2kp cos theta by r square is equals to E multiplied by 2r cos theta. So here we can directly calculate the value of electric field as 2 cos theta gets cancelled out and the value of electric field is 2kp by r cube, or here we are required to find the radius. So I'll calculate the value of r, which can be given as kp by e to whole power 1 by 3, that is cube root of kp by e. That is the answer to this problem.